Hello students, this is Vinay sir, your mathematics teacher. Once again I welcome you all to the online class organized by Alchemy School. In previous class we all have started the exercise 6.1. We had taken many questions. Today we are going to continue the same exercise. We will take the next question, and the next question is question number 6. So let's see what is given in question number 6. According to question number 6, using the given pattern, find the missing number. In this question, we have to follow the given pattern and we have to find the missing numbers. Okay, you can see many numbers are missing in this pattern and we have to find these missing numbers. Okay, so let's study the pattern first. So when we observe the pattern, we can see when we multiply these two numbers, we are getting the third number. And when we add 1 in this third number, we get the final result. So this procedure we have to apply in entire question to find the missing numbers. Okay, so let's see. When we multiply these two number, 1 square plus 2 square, we get 2 square. And when we add 1 in this 2 square, we get 3 square. Okay, the same way, when we multiply 2 square and 3 square, we get 6 square. 2 threes are 6. And when we add 1 in this 6 square, we get 7 square. The same way, when we multiply 3 square and 4 square, we get 12 square. And when we add 1 in this 12 square, we get 13 square. The same way, when we multiply 4 square and 5 square, 4 fives are 20. So the first number that we are going to get here is 20 square. And when we add 1 in this 20, we get 20 square, that is given here. When we multiply 5 and this number, we get 30 square. So which number is multiplied by 5? So we get 30 square. So easily we can say 5, 6 are 30. So this will be 6 square. And when we add 1 in this 30, we get 31 square. The same way, when we multiply 6 and 7, we get 7, 6 are 42. So this will be 42 square. And when we add 1 in this 42, we get 43 square. Okay, so students, you can see here we all have found all these missing numbers by observing and following the given patterns. Okay, so practice for this thing and we are going to see the next question. So let's see the next question, that is question number 7. Okay, so according to question number 7, without adding, find the sum. Okay, you can see some numbers are given here. And we have to find the sum of these number without adding them. Okay, so how we can find it? Let's discuss. Okay, when we observe these numbers, we can see these are the successive odd numbers. Okay, these all are the odd numbers. This is 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So these all are the successive odd numbers. Okay, when we add these things, 1, 3, 4, 4 and 5, 9, 9 and 7, 16, 16 and 9, 25. Okay, so we can write here 25. But it is given in question, we are not going to add these numbers and we have to find the sum. So students, we can see these are the odd numbers and how many odd numbers are here? So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. These are the 5 successive odd number, first 5 successive odd number. These are the first 5 successive odd number. Okay, so we can write here sum of first 5 successive odd number will be 5 square is equal to 25. Okay, the same way when we observe the next number, this is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17 and 19. So these all are also odd numbers. And how many odd numbers are here? So we can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So these are 10. So these are first 10 successive odd number. So we can write here in the second number. In the second number, we can write sum of first 10 successive odd numbers will be 10 square is equal to 100. Okay, so we can write the sum of these numbers will be 100. When we observe the next number, it is 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21 and 23. So when we observe these numbers, these are also odd number. So when we are going to find the sum of these odd numbers, we have to find how many successive odd numbers they are. Okay, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. So we can write here in the third number, sum of first 12 successive odd numbers will be 12 square is equal to 144. On the conclusion of this question, students, we can write here the sum of n successive odd numbers will be n square. Okay, so if we are going to find the sum of one successive odd number will be 1 square, if we are going to find the sum of first 2 successive odd number, it will be 2 square, if we are going to find the sum of first 3 successive odd number, definitely it will be 3 square. So easily we can say the sum of first n successive odd numbers will be n square. That's it. Okay, let's see the next question of the exercise, that is question number 8. Okay students, so question number 8 is based on the question number 7 we have discussed here. Okay, so you can solve the question number 8 by yourself. We are going to take the next question, that is question number 9. So let's see what is given in question number 9. According to question number 9, how many numbers lie between the square of the following numbers? Okay, so we can see two numbers are given here and we have to find the numbers lying between the square of these two given numbers. So first of all, we have to find the square of 12. So we can find here this 12 square, it will be 144, and the 13 square, and it will be 169. So now we have to find the numbers which are lying between 144 and 169. Okay, so we can see the numbers are 145, 146, 147, 148, 149, 150, 151, 152, 153, 154, 155, 156, 157, 158, 159, 160, 161, 162, 163, 164, 165, 166, 167 and 168. So these are the numbers which are lying between the square of 12 and the square of 13. How many numbers they are? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23 and 24. So finally we can write here, there are 24 numbers lying between the square of 12 and 13. Okay, so this is the way how we can find the numbers lying between the square of two given number. Okay, you can follow the procedure and you can solve the remaining questions by yourself. We have completed the exercise 6.1 here. When we meet again, then we'll discuss some more important points. Till then, keep practicing, keep learning, stay safe and stay at home. Thank you so much.